Hello there, and welcome to this video. Let's see quickly how to make professional 3D renderings with AutoCAD 2018. Leave us suggestions and comments in the video description to improve our next video guides for this software. In the previous videos of this guide, we have seen how to add color, gradient, and pattern filling to your projects by using the hatch command. However, this is suitable for 2D drawings, laying on the XY ground plane or any plane parallel to it. You can still use it on 3D objects, but these may be filled only partially. There are several ways to color and fill 3D objects, depending on the kind of view used and on the details you want to obtain. The most simple way to fully color a 3D object is to change its basic color. Click on the object to select it, and go to the Properties section under the Home tab to change its color. In case you use any wireframe view, you will see all the object edges with the new color. Whereas to apply several colors on the faces and edges of the 3D object, you have to use the color tools inside the Solid Editing section under the 3D Tools tab. Use Color Edges to select the interested edges of the object, applying with the Enter key, and then selecting the color you like on the Select Color window. Here, under Index Color, you have all the standard AutoCAD colors, and under True Color, all the RGB colors if you want to get one customized. These colored edges are visible just in case a wireframe view is used. Whereas, you can use color faces to apply these colors on the selected faces of the object. In this case, remember to use a 3D view. These tools can also be used multiple times to apply different colors on a same object. For more professional renderings, 3D materials are applied on these objects. With respect to a flat solid color, these materials also give other properties to your objects, such as brightness, reflectivity, transparency, and so on. You can find the materials inside the Visualize tab, which is usually hidden by default. To show it, just right-click on a vacant space on top and go to Show Tabs and then to Visualize. Let's see how to import and apply materials to your 3D objects. On the Visualize tab, click on the first button inside the Materials section to open the Materials browser. On top, you have all the materials imported inside your project, and more at the bottom, all the materials available inside the Autodesk Library folder. At first, a single material is available called Global, which is the default one used to render your 3D objects. You can import other materials by selecting one from the list and dragging and dropping it on top. Once the material is imported, you can apply it on an object by dragging the material on it. If you want to apply the material on specific object faces, make sure to select them by holding Ctrl down, and then click on the material you want to apply. Consider that materials affect only the object faces, so you won't see any change to its edges at all. Each of these materials can be completely customized by double-clicking on it. This opens the Materials Editor, containing all the material properties that defines its appearance, color, basic pattern, glossiness, and reflectivity. Check a quick preview on top, and eventually change it by using the small button next to it. To save all modifications, just close the editor. You can also rename and delete a material by right-clicking on it and using Rename or Delete from the Materials browser. The realistic view shows a good preview of your project in progress, but still it hides important details. To check an advanced and professional rendering on your 3D objects, you have to use the Render tools, all contained inside the Visualize tab. Click on the Render button to open the Render window. This shows the final appearance of your project after rendering by applying the same identical point of view of your workspace. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out and check out the Render Progress bar at the bottom. All the complete renderings are listed at the bottom by clicking on the down arrow on the left from the most recent one from the top. Click on one to select it and check its preview again. Use the buttons on top to save it and print it if you need. Inside the render section, you have several options. The first bar is used to select the proper render quality. The higher it is, the more time you may wait before its completion. Right below the render button, you can select the proper resolution to use in pixels. The second bar below the quality is used to change the way to render your project. For example, Render in Window saves your rendering results inside a dedicated window, as seen before, giving you the possibility to save and print them. But in case you need a fast rendering, you may prefer to render in Viewport or Region. Viewport simply renders your project directly on your workspace, whereas Region renders the part of the project you specifically select on the workspace in order to save time. You can check its progress through the progress bar inside the render section. Consider that the rendering results will vanish when you change the point of view of your workspace. For more advanced rendering options, click on Render Preset Manager. To enhance the rendering of your project, you can also add light, sky, and proper environment. Let's see how to do this. To add sunlight, click on Sun Status inside Sun and Location. Accept the recommended settings, and a new panel called Render Environment and Exposure opens. Turn on Environment and adjust Exposure and White Balance, more at the bottom. Apply a quick Viewport or Region rendering to see the final lighting on your project. On top, on Sun and Location, you can also adjust the sunlight source by setting location, date, and hour. Besides the basic sunlight, you can also add secondary light sources by using the first button of the lights section. Point applies a source that is placed on a fixed point and spreads light in any direction. Click on the workspace to fix it and use the Enter key to apply. Then click on it to select it and edit its properties. Use the light section to adjust its light properties and its gizmo system to move it through the three axis directions. Spot adds a source that spreads light within a defined cone, just like a torch. Fix a first point to place the spotlight, and then a second one for its target. Use the Enter key to apply. To edit it, click on it to select it, and use the light section for its light properties, and use the blue nodes to change the way to spread its light. For example, move the squared node to move the target, the blue arrow close to it to define the light range, and the external arrows to regulate the cone radius and its feather. Also, the spotlight will get a gizmo system when it is selected in order to move it where you like. Consider that it will change direction automatically in order not to lose its target. There are also other lights called distant and web light. Check them out. Additionally, you can also render a more professional environment by adding ceiling or sky. If you switch to a perspective view in the bottom right corner of the 3D view cube and you have environment turned on in the render environment panel, you will get a ceiling in preview depending on what you choose as image-based lighting. However, this is completely independent from the sunlight properties chosen. To realize sky, which is dependent on the sunlight, just turn off the environment and select Sky Background from Sun and Location. As for the ground or the floor, you may need to realize it manually by using 3D and mesh objects. From the light section, you can also apply shadows. Choose Ground Shadows to show all shadows with respect to the sunlight. Choose Full Shadows to apply shadows coming from the secondary lights you have added inside your project. Thanks for watching this video. Follow us and subscribe for more amazing and free video guides on Autodesk software.